Where are we? We are on problem 15. Problem 15. And I'll do that in yellow. Problem 15. And let's see, they have a bunch of triangles drawn. So let me get the line tool and see what I can do about drawing these. So I've got a big triangle that looks something like that. It's the big triangle, and there's this altitude that drops down. Drops down like that, and then there's a smaller triangle within it that looks something like this. Something like this. This is the smaller triangle. And then this is a 90 degree angle right here. It's perpendicular. This is the Q, S, P, V. Oh my god, no, I messed up. Let's see how far I could. Let's see, I'm going to have to erase some. I should have done this ahead of time. I'm wasting your time, but bear with me. I drew this line wrong. This line does something different. That line looks like this. Looks like this. Alright, now I'm back in business. Excuse me if I burp, I just ate an apple. Okay, I'm wasting your time. T and then R. It took me almost 2 minutes just to draw this thing. And it says, note, figure not drawn to scale. And it says, in triangle PQR above, QS over QV, QS over QV is equal to 1/3. And it says, PT over PR is equal to 3/4. What is the value of the fraction? And they want to know area of triangle PST over area of triangle PQR. Now let's see what we can do. I haven't been thinking just yet. I've just been drawing and writing. So they say QS over QV over this whole thing is 1/3. Fair enough. And they say PT over PR is equal to 3/4. Okay, fair enough. So area of PST over area of PQR. So what's the area of PST? PST. So area of triangle PST. That would be just the base times the height. Times 1/2, right? 1/2, and we'll see that the 1/2s cancel out. We don't have to do them, but I'll do it just to figure it out. So it's 1/2, and PT, 1/2 PT times, 1/2 PT times SV, and then area of P. QR is going to be 1/2, so it's this whole thing, PR times QV, right? Times QV. So the area of this triangle PST over the area of triangle PQR, well, it's just going to be 1/2 PT times SV over 1/2 times the area of PQR, so it's over this, 1/2 PR times QV. And let's see what we could figure out. We definitely see the 1/2s cancel out. And, well, do we know what PT over PR is? Let me see. PT over PR. PT over PR, they give it right here. PT over PR is 3/4. So this term is equal to 3/4, so this is equal to 3/4 times SV over QV. And now we're at the conundrum. We know what QV is, right? But we only know QS. We don't know SV. But let me ask you a question. If QS over QV over this whole thing is 1/3, so this distance, this pink distance right here, This peak distance is one-third of this entire length, right? Because this distance over the entire distance is one-third. Then SV over QV, so then this is going to be two-thirds, right? If this is one-third, this will be two-thirds. So then we know that SV, that's what we're trying to figure out here, SV over the whole thing is going to be two-thirds. So this is two-thirds. And then three-fourths times two-thirds, well, the threes cancel out, and you get two-fourths. It equals one-half. And you just fill it in. Next problem. Hope you get that. Most of it we just figured out what the areas were and just substituted. And then we just had to figure out what SV over QV is given QS over QV, right? And we knew that we figured out that SV over QV is two-thirds. I hope I did not confuse you. It's Thanksgiving, and it's not a good day to confuse people. Okay, number 16. Let the function h be defined by, I enjoy these, h of x is equal to 14 plus x squared over 4. If h of 2m is equal to 9m, so it tells us that h of 2m is equal to 9m, what is one possible value of m? Well, let's just figure out what h of 2m is. So h of 2m, if we put it into that, h of 2m is equal to, just using this definition of its function, 14 plus, well, we're taking h of 2m, so it's 2m squared over 4. And we also know that this is equal to 9m. Right? And let's see what we can do to simplify it. So we could say 14 plus 4m squared over 4, just squaring both of these, is equal to 9. This cancels out, right? And then we are, it's equal to 9m, sorry. And now we're left with 14 plus m squared is equal to 9m. We're left with a quadratic. It might not be obvious to you. Let's subtract 9m from both sides and rearrange a little bit, and you get m squared minus 9m plus 14 is equal to 0. All it is, I took this m, 9m, put it on this side, subtracted 9m from both sides, and put the m squared out for front. Now we have a quadratic, and we need to solve, figure out where this expression intersects the x-axis, or figure out the roots of this quadratic. And we can factor this, right? If you remember your factoring from later algebra 1 or some algebra 2, this would be m minus 7 times m minus 2 is equal to 0. And how did I figure that out? Well, I had to figure out two numbers that when I multiply them equals positive 14, and that when I add them is equal to negative 9, right? So 14, 9, well, 7 times 2 is 14, or negative 7 times negative 2 is also 14. And we know it's negative because it has to go to negative 9. And that's just a review of what you learned in algebra class. If this was confusing, you might want to review factoring. But anyway, if m minus 7 times m minus 2 is equal to 0, that means that m is equal to 7 or 2. And you can fill in either one of those, because they say, what is one possible value for m? I have a minute left, so, and oh boy, I only had two problems left. Well, that's good for one extra video. So I'll see you in the next.